What is up, YouTube? What is going on? I bet you're wondering, what the heck is this guy doing? So basically, I'm about to go ahead and start the wrap process of wrapping the exhaust for Harley. I got the stainless steel zip ties. I got the DEI exhaust wrap, and we got water. So the first step is to soak the wrap. From what I've heard, just to get it more pliable, you want to soak your wrap in the water for, it says 10 to 15 minutes. To get it wet thoroughly through, it's best to unravel it like I'm doing here. We're going to wrap it. I'm not doing a full wrap like some people do. Mine is going to be a partial wrap. That's why I don't have as much, and the pipes are pretty short. So let me let this soak. And I'll be right back with you. I'm not going to be able to show the full wrapping process because this is going to get messy. And I'm not going to have anyone hold the camera. I might show as I start and when I finish. But we'll just jump to that. Here we are. I got the first pipe. I'm going to start with the smaller one. Okay. Here we go. I got the first exhaust pipe I'm going to start on, which will be the small one. And what I'm going to do... it's hard to hold the camera and show you, but I'm going to wrap from bottom going up. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start my wrap and then put one of the stainless steel zip ties around it to hold it. So I'll show you that once I get that done. I'll be completely honest with y'all. I tried to stop, but it's really hard to stop once you get started because the wrap keeps coming apart. But I got it wrapped and strapped. I just got to cut the ties off the back and then let it dry, and I'm hoping this holds pretty good, but that's all that I'm wrapping on this pipe. And now I'm gonna do the next one. So I got both pipes wrapped the way I wanted them wrapped, two straps on the bottom, and it wraps about halfway up the pipe, and I put three on the top. I just have to let this moisture dry out so I can spray it with silicone, and tomorrow I'm gonna go buy some clips to clip all these extra wires off so that it'll look a lot cleaner. So I'll just cut the video to once I cut those clips, and then after that we'll put some spray on them, and then we'll get them put on the bike, because she's over here waiting for it. She is waiting. But I think it's gonna look really nice. It looked like it'll mount like right there, and it'll come down like that. But I'll show y'all once I finish everything up. So I'm gonna just cut till tomorrow when I can cut these wire zip ties off. All right, what's going on, YouTube? It is 6:23 in the a.m. I'm an early bird. I don't really sleep. And last night, I basically sprayed the exhaust with the high temp silicone coating to protect it, and it basically made it darker black. But it's supposed to protect that coating. And now what I'm gonna do is peel off the tape that I put on here to protect the chrome or the stainless steel zip ties. So let me get that off and I'll be right back. So I got the tape off, as you can see, and it's still showing the stainless steel. This stupid cat is getting on my nerves. Next step is to put the rings back on the tip of the exhaust. Basically, you just slide this piece over. The exhaust should slide right on. Give me a second to try to get that on there. Sorry it took a second, but as you can see, you get the ring on there. Then you gotta slide this little metal clip over it to hold it in place. Now I'm gonna clean this up a little bit because it looks a little rusty. Then I'll be right back with both installed on the exhaust. Okay, so now I got the clips on there, which basically you slide this on first, as you can see, and then the retainer clip, I don't know if you can see it, is right in there. The next step, before you can even put the exhaust on, is going to be, it's probably hard to see in there, let me shine some light. See that ring right there? Looks like shredded steel wool. Gotta get that out, because you gotta replace that with a new one. So let me get that out and then I'll show you what it looks like. As you can see, I was able to get that out. It's just solid steel now. And the piece fell. Let me grab it
And that's basically the piece that came out.
It's basically just a gasket, which is like a steel wool type filling material. And I got to go get the new ones and throw those in.
Okay, so we got the new rings. I'm going to go ahead and put these in real quick.
Basically, grab the ring. Make sure it fits flush in there. I'm doing this with one hand, so it's not that easy.
All right, as you can see,
got the ring in flush. Now I'm going to move and do the other side.
Okay, so I myself like to add a little bit of penetrating oil to the bolt right here that I'm going to be mounting it down to. Just make it go on smoother and lubricated. And the easiest way is just spray a little bit on the rag, grab it, take it up there, and just rub it around the bolt. So I'm gonna do that to all these bolts real quick. And the main reason I do that, just so the bolts will go on easier. And I got some brand new fasteners right here that I'm gonna put on. Next step, insert your torque converter. Now the torque converter basically goes on first. It's gonna go in the hole, this piece like this, and this part comes out into the exhaust pipe. It basically goes on, let's say the exhaust is right here where my finger is. The engine's right here where my finger is. It goes up against that exhaust exit from the engine, like this. And then this tube goes into the exhaust. If you really want to know the easiest way to do it, I say just grab this, stick it down in the tube of the exhaust. And then just go from there, push the exhaust up to it.
Okay, so I got the exhaust on. I started it for a quick second, but it's too early in the morning and it's really, really loud. And that's why the exhausts are smoking. I guess it's gonna have some burn off period. So what I'll do is I'll cut to when, a little later in the day, when I started, let y'all hear how it sounds. But I think it went on, looks pretty good. It was a little tough to line up, I'm not gonna even lie. It was a pain in the butt getting on there, but we got it on, it's snug down, it's tight. I ran it for like 5 minutes and no issues, doesn't seem loose at all. So I'll cut to later on in the day when I can pull the bike outside and restart it for y'all.
Okay, since it stopped raining, let me pull the bike out real quick just to do the sound test. So just give me a second to get her out. This ain't easy, y'all. Get right there. All right, so I'm gonna start it up real quick, let it run for just a little bit so y'all can get a sound. Pipes are what they say, LAF. It's loud as fuck, but I still got a lot of burn off to go where it's gonna have to burn off whatever's on the pipes, the coating, because it's doing a lot of smoking. And I know that takes a little while, a couple days or whatnot, so I'm gonna let that happen. But yeah, I'll give you all my overall review of these exhaust pipes once I have ridden with it quite a bit and checked it out and see how everything works. But for now, it's your boy Infinite Rider signing out. Glad I got it all taken care of today. I might work on my levers later and finish all the parts I still got to put on here. But make sure you hit that subscribe button, like and comment below, and I will see you in the next one.